watching Squatchy Brew Dude Beer Visits on BFC.
Cincinnati is a wonderful city. It's located in Ohio, USA.
Okay.
It's called Cincinnati.
I'm at the rooftop.
Right on the border with the Kentucky floor. Yeah. Ohio River, Licking River.
Great street side.
Yeah, yeah. Cincinnati, Ohio.
Really cool place.
Lots of people living there.
One of these tanks.
Go Reds, go Bengals, oh yeah.
This is a big facility, quite impressive.
You should go downtown and take a look around. So much good stuff going on in Cincinnati. It's got a thriving downtown business area. Cincinnati's got a lot of nice people living in it. All the people in Cincinnati are wonderful. Cincinnati is the best place in the world.
Great name of a beer, Retirement Porter. Hola muchachos, it's time for a brew. A Hustle IPA from Rheingeist. Yeah, it's easy drinking West Coast style IPA. It's pretty good.
Chilling on the patio here over in Streetside. Here at Streetside. It's this is where the magic happens. It's pretty sexy. Really cool place. Funny thing is, the news actually came in here. I was trying to upstage me with some young hot chick and some big camera. Good times, good beer. I'll get some more footage here. Yeah, I had Gronk here, and he was a pain in the ass quality mini still a beer, so. It is a crazy day in the hood. Happy Gronk! Gronk! Das Boot. They're expanding here at Streetside. It's pretty killer. It's a good time.
Right across from Xavier University is a cool brewery called Listerman. A few homebrewers may have known these guys from the Phil Mill, the Phil's False Bottom. Right now they crank out some crazy beers.
Let's give these guys a try.
This is where all the sexy magic happens. I'm at Listerman. Got a flight here. I got the Bacon Fryer Bock, the Lemon Blonde, Lemon Cake Blonde, the Flintlock Stout, and the Black New England IPA. Oh wow. Oh wow. Definitely taste the bacon. Definitely the first beer I've ever had with bacon. This is pretty good. Going with a lemon cake blonde. Oh, that's good. Tastes like lemon cake. In the Flintlock here. Oh wow, that's nice. Coffee, vanilla, lactose. Doesn't taste 10 and a half. This is
easy drinking. That's nice. Yeah, this is good stuff.
There's a sexy flight. Let's try the Black New England IPA.
Mythic Porter, or I'm sorry, West Coast IPA.
Y'all, this is sexy. 99 bottles of beer on the wall, 99 bottles of beer. I think landfill died
in one of these tanks. This is a big facility, quite impressive. Quite impressive. They need that much. There is so many frickin' people here today. Frickin' everybody and their brother is here. You gotta come to Mad Tree. Beer's pretty good. And the people watching alone, facility's beautiful.
Cincinnati, one of the biggest ones, Briggs Breweries here in Cincinnati as well. It is called Rheingeist. We pretty much have Truth IPA on every tap handle in town. Let's check. Pretty sexy here, gotta admit. A nice job on this historical space.
Yeah, if you've never been here, I mean, your first time in Cincinnati, this is definitely one of the
spots you need to check out. It's got a lot of character. Main bar. Got a cloud harvest. New England IPA.
Okay, I'm at the rooftop at Rheingeist, and I have a hustle here to drink, and I gotta admit, it is really killer up here. You get a view of downtown. Here's the outdoor bar on the rooftop. I'll show us a little bit of more. In the distance over there, the steel tanks over there, the steel tanks. That's focusing on us.
That's where basically all the same atoms Boston Lager is made. Right there, Cincinnati, Ohio, not Boston. There's a little soccer stadium. Yeah, it's really cool up here.
Great name of a beer, Retirement Porter. Real close. I like it a lot.
So I'm drinking a retirement porter here up at the rooftop at Rheingeist. Rheingeist, y'all. It's pretty good. And if you look in the distance here, let's get a little closer. I don't know, it's like 2 blocks away. You'll see the Sam Adams tap room. It's right over there, right in the middle of that old golden building. You have to stop there. I've been there a few times, not recently, but today might be the day. Well, it's so nice after all the shitty weather we've been having here in the Cincinnati. Then we got some nice sunshine. Here at the Samuel Adams tap room.
main breweries over there. You can see the tanks I showed you earlier, but it's good beer.
Here at the Sam Adams Brewery.
It's been a while since I've had one of these. I think I put Jim Cook's two kids through Harvard back in the 90s with all the stuff I used to drink. I don't drink too much of it anymore. I must say, it's really good. They have a little pilot brewery in here. They do some smaller stuff. Cool spot. As you can see, I'm crushing this Sam Adams Boston Lager. I gotta tell you, I haven't had one of these in quite a while. This thing is so freaking fresh. This is one of the best lagers I've had in a long time. It is fucking amazing. Oh my god. You gotta come here. I highly recommend coming here and get one of these. This is the best lager you'll drink. Trying some of the Cincinnati originals here. What's the other thing?
Hasta la vista, baby.
It's not bad.
There's the 513 Amber Lager. It's like a subdued Sam Adams. This is the year. It's a Hellas.
I see you in hell, my friend.
Well, that's crushable.
Love being back in a time machine. Scooty sunshine. Haven't seen the sun in for fucking ever here in Cincinnati. Look at that shit. Holy shit, I'm blinded by sun. When I feel cold, you want me.
In a Sonder, this is one of the close breweries that I go to, one of the home breweries, I guess I would call them. Okay. Here at Sonder, drinking a rally cap, and it doesn't appear to be helping the Cincinnati Reds much. I think they've lost 10 straight, 11 straight.
She had a little something like this. But I think she probably got,
she's
gotta have more.
Oh, that's nice. Crisp lager. And Sonder here, trying the Hefeweizen. See what the wonderful Chase has done here. Oh, wow. Very refreshing. Get some clove. Oh, and that banana. From the yeast. That's nice. Sonder Brewing. Going with a Sonder. You betcha. New England IPA. Ah, bueno, señor. I'm drinking the award-winning from the GABF Higher Purpose Milk Stout at Third Eye here in Cincinnati / Sharonville, Ohio.
It's a pretty good size. It's like a
this
basket.
Sharonville is the hometown of Baywatch, the former Baywatch Carmen Electra actress. Let's try this guy. Third Eye Milk Stout.
Absolutely, you got some
drink. Oh, very nice. That's what I'm talking about. Nice. Good life, too good. Drink beer. I'm free.
You're watching Squatchy Brew Dude Beer Visits here on
the Brewery and Food Channel, and we are live here at the Brink Brewery in Cincinnati. What an awesome spot. Killer beers. West side of Cincinnati, you gotta check these guys out. They're in my top five for sure.
Maiden Voyage, Maiden IPA. Oh, that's really good. Oh, perfect on it. 81 degree day like today.
A loco loco. Yeah, very small brewery, company of the year.
It really smells like hop. These guys are insane.
So I'm staying classy here in Cincinnati, drinking a Ron Burgundy Fruited Sour. That is the actual name of the beer.
What about these medals these guys got? They are flat simple.
Look at those JBF medals. Those are seven of them. It's pretty impressive for the size of this brewery. If you come to Cincinnati, I recommend these guys. They know their shit. Good stuff.
Gotta go to Skyline Chili, and you gotta pick up some cheese conies, and you also gotta get some of this spaghetti chili where they throw a bunch of the cheese on. I might show it to you later. I haven't got it for my kid, but I'm gonna have a cheese cone. So you people not in Cincinnati have maybe never seen it. What Cincinnati chili is, cheese coney. Throw a shitload of cheese, and it's basically some weird chili that has like cinnamon in it. It's good. It takes a while to grow on you. My wife hates it. My son and I love it. I think it's pretty good. So, I don't know. If you're in Cincinnati, give it a try.
Cincinnati is a wonderful city. It's a great beer city. Hey, thanks for watching the Squatchy Brew Dude Beer Visits here on the Brewery and Food Channel. Want to give a shout out to the dude that writes songs and sings songs about random cities like Cincinnati. Pretty freaking killer. I know this guy existed. He writes a song about like every town. You got to check him out. It's freaking hilarious. Oh, also, thank you very much to my 16 subscribers. I love you guys. You guys freaking rock. Thanks for joining the party bus. This is going to be a lot of fun. Hell, it already is a lot of fun, but it's going to get much more fun. So, hey, I want to let's talk about how great of a beer city it is. It wasn't always that way when I moved here in 2005. In 2005, Cincinnati was muy, muy debil. Super weak. We had two brewery tap rooms. One was a Rock Bottom. The other was a Hofbrauhaus over in Newport, Kentucky, which is still in existence, which it's a fun place, but there wasn't much. Listerman was a homebrew shop. They had no tap room. So, hey, things have changed for the better. Thank God. I think we have about 50 or 60 breweries. And I'd say 20 of them were probably pretty good. 10, I would say, are really good. We've got a lot of mediocre, too, unfortunately. But we've got some fortunate enough to have some great breweries. And I'm going to talk about the ones that I really like, the ones you saw in the video for the most part. I probably have to make another video because there are so many of them. And there's some other ones that are pretty good. We didn't even talk about food here. Listerman. Oh, I'll give you my top list here. Number one, Listerman. If you like crazy homebrew beers, New England IPAs, barrel-aged stouts, if you want a beer that tastes like bacon, a beer that tastes like lemon pound cake, a hazelnut imperial brown with chicao, 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 a place. This is your place, man. I advise you to get flights there because not all their beers translate into full pours. Get flights, you will be absolutely delighted. This place is insane. They're my favorite. They're definitely my favorite. So much creativity. I've never had a bad time there. They are killer. Number two, I'd go with Streetside. And oddly enough, I think one of their brewers came from Listerman. They kind of do, they make a lot more New England IPAs, which are my favorite. Some West Coast IPAs. Also some pastry stouts. They do some other fun stuff. They make, if you're into sours, they're big into sours. That's kind of not my jam, but I use it as a palate cleanser. But yeah, they do a little bit of sours there. Number three, I'd go with Brink. They, as you can see with all their metals, they do everything well. They make a nice, easy drinking milk stout with Moosey. I really love that Maiden Voyage New England IPA. They do everything well. They can make lagers. I had a sour there, the Ron Burgundy, Steak Classy, Cincinnati. You know, it's really not my jam. It's kind of a palate cleanser. It was okay. But their other beers are really solid. I'm just not a sour guy. I mean, a lot of people like Urban Artifact, which their stuff's just too puckery. You just got to douse a sour in fruit for me to drink it. And, you know, it's just, we don't all like the same thing. So maybe not all of you love IPAs. So we like different stuff. I get it. It's America. Thank you very much. So then number four, I would go with Third Eye over in Sharonville. Oddly enough, one of their brewers came over from Brink, and it's basically drinking the Brink beers closer to my house. They're basically one of the breweries that I attend most often because it's close to where I live. They make everything from, they won, you know, the Higher Purpose stout's great. I think Astral stout's a big, more of an imperial one. That's pretty solid. They make really nice New England IPAs, lagers. They do everything. They had a sour there my wife had that was actually pretty good because it was like doused in fruit and it was Candy Crush sour or something. It was really good. So I highly recommend them. They would be my number four brewery here in Cincinnati. Number five, I would go with Sonder up in Mason. Chase does a real good job on those German beers. The Hefeweizen is fantastic. The Rally Cap Pilsner, very nice, very nice. They also make, You Betcha is a solid New England IPA, and they also do a milkshake frosted series with usually different fruits. The Mango, my wife goes crazy about that beer. That's pretty decent milkshake IPA, and they do a really bang-up job there over at Sonder. Next, number six, I would go with, you can flip-flop these guys, Rheingeist, you definitely have to check them out. That rooftop is really sexy. Mad Tree, that brewery is really sexy. And both of those places are just going to be totally packed with people having a good time. And those are places probably have the coolest atmosphere in town. So if you want, you know, like if you want to go to a place for the atmosphere and soak up and see a lot of young people, definitely check those places out. They even let geezers in like me. So there's actually, as I said, a couple older, man, maybe one or two people that are actually older than me. And then if you're down in that Rheingeist area, check out Sam Adams. That's a really cool tap room. I know it might not be that cool to drink Boston Lager anymore, but man, that beer was super fresh and was fantastic. And they have their little pilot brewery and they make a lot of interesting beers there. So, and it's a beautiful tap room, nice place. And if you're also down there in the opposite direction, like two blocks north of Rheingeist, there's a brewery called Northern Row, and they also make booze, vodka, and, you know, whiskey or whatever the heck it is. It's good stuff. I mean, the beer, I don't drink the other hard stuff. I know my limits. So, yeah, definitely check them out. It's a cool historic space. They make their IPAs are more of like English varieties, but they do a nice job. I think they make a beer called Wanka, you bloody Wanka. It's good stuff. So next, another few other places I might check out are Nine Giant. They're pretty good. High Green. They're up in the Montgomery area. Nine Giant's not far from them. And Braxton, they make a pretty good New England IPA, and they do some barrel aging as well. Maybe I can show them on another video in the future. Another place a lot of people like if you're into sours is Urban Artifact, but again, that's not my jam. I just not really into sours, but a lot of people just go apeshit over them. So if that's your jam, check them out. So hey, as you can see, Cincinnati is a wonderful beer city. Definitely come to Cincinnati for a long weekend. There's lots of beer to drink for sure, and it's really good now. It's solid. Click and subscribe if you can. Also, I'm on Twitter, Squatchy Brew Dude. I post pictures basically of beer, maybe my dog, and smiles. No bitching. We're here just for fun. We're here for fun. Don't take ourselves too serious, for sure. So then, once again, thank you for watching the Squatchy Brew Dude Beer Visits on the Brewery and Food channel. And hopefully we will get out west, maybe for good. Or at least for a vacation. I'm due. San Diego, Oregon. You got to check these guys out. Great notion if you're ever in Portland area. So, hey, thanks for watching the Squatchy Brew Dude Beer Visits on BFC. And chillax, bros. Happy IPA drinking. Thanks for watching.